What does a field engineer do with lift drawings? In this short video, I'm going to explain to you exactly what a field engineer does with lift drawings and where this term came from. It's absolutely remarkable. I recommend it for every job site, and I think you're gonna love it. So stay with me on this video. Okay, so this was a question that was given to me the other day by a great superintendent, and I'm super happy to answer it here on the channel. Here's the deal. You have your plans, and actually, let me just write down architectural, structural, mechanical, plumbing, your technology drawings, right? Your civil drawings. I'm probably missing something, but you have your plans, and then you have your specs, and then you have your shop drawings, or maybe it's just a regular submittal for a product. You have, you know, AHJ requirements, you have code requirements. A lift drawing is to say, hey, this is like, let's say these are perimeter walls for an underground structure, right? You're gonna take one placement, one wall, and you're gonna go ahead and take that. Let's say the wall from a side view looks like this. Maybe there's a step down footing here, right? I don't know how the footing would look. Typically it steps, but maybe there's reinforcing coming out, some embeds and opening, maybe some reinforcing coming out the side, you know, whatever the case may be, maybe there's another embed. That one wall, that one thing, that one component, you're gonna go build a lift drawing, lifts the information from all these drawing sets and puts it in one location for you to build. Now I'm gonna make this really simple. There are, ooh, and I can link these to you. There's a lift drawing review card. There's other information for how to create lift drawings. You can typically do this in Revit or AutoCAD or SketchUp, however the company or the person decides to do it. But let me tell you what a field engineer uses it for. And this is the right order. Number one, to learn the scope. That is number one. There's no better way to teach a field engineer what is entailed with the scope that they're gonna go help. Layout, support, enable, QC, other than to read these drawings and create a lift drawing. Number two, to find and solve problems. So here is a great quote. Scott Berg, one time, who is a general superintendent that trained me, I don't know if he'd admit that now, but he trained me. He would say, if you can't draw it, you can't build it. If we don't have enough information to draw it, we're not gonna have enough information to build it. So when you're actually creating the lift drawing, you're finding and solving problems. And then number three, you have a drawing for install. Now, here's the key. Some people say, and I'll close out with this, hey, I'm not doing self-perform, I don't need lift drawings. Wrong. Or hey, my people don't need your drawing to install, so we don't need lift drawings. Wrong. If you want to build the supers of the future, you'd better train them as FEs, and they'd better be doing lift drawings, because there's no better way to train a builder than doing lift drawings. That's the purpose of lift drawings, to train future superintendents, read drawings, visualize in 3D, piece together components, and become a builder. One, two, three, that's the way to do it. So even if you didn't use the drawing to install in the field, you've still trained that builder. This is why field engineers do lift drawings and what they use them for. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.